I'm just gonna skip the intro, hit subscribe. I wanna watch this.
If y'all can read this on me, but I'm incredibly grateful, and I'm really, really nervous to be here, but I never thought of this would happen. And this right here, this is just me, okay? Yeah, this is a version of me that I've never got to introduce to you guys before. This is just me. Being me, genuine me, for the first time. And I just want to share with you, you know, this past year in my life, I lost a lot of things. I lost my career. I love you too. I lost my career. I lost my self-confidence. I lost two people who were very, very close to me. And I lost my way. And I got to a point where I thought that everything that I'd ever done here or otherwise, I thought it was all meaningless. Nothing I ever did has mattered to anyone. And I was wrong. I was wrong. Once I was done feeling sorry for myself and I decided to go out in the world again and see people, there were people everywhere, they would say, "Thank you, Bray, man. When you coming back home?" And then every once in a while, there would be someone I would meet that's truly remarkable. And you know who you are. But these people, they would come to me. They would come to me and they would say, "Bray, I just wanted to thank you, man, because I was in a time of need and I lost people that were close to me and I lost my self-confidence and I felt weak and I felt vulnerable. And in this weakened state, I found your words, Bray. I found your words and I just wanted to thank you, man. You saved my life, Bray." Truth is, I don't think about stuff like that. And the thing about that is that I can sit here right now today and I can look all of you in the eyes and I can say that you were there when I was weak, when I was vulnerable, when I was down. So I just wanted to say thank you. You all saved my life. You wouldn't let me alone. Every time I tried to run away and hide, you were there to find me. When I left things behind, you found them. You chased me. You are the reason.
Oh, little one, my little one. Come. Come with me. Your life is done. Forget the future. Forget the past. Life is over. Breathe your last. You got no idea who you're dealing with, do you? Ooh, but you will. You will.
Man, I don't even know what to say. Like, I know I joke a lot on this channel, but man, there is nothing about that to joke about. Like, I'm blown away. Like every time he comes back or does anything, it's always like this. The first thing that came to mind is that as emotional as this is with him coming back, the whole speech, the heart-to-heart that he gave to everybody, letting the fans know that he appreciates them and they're the reason why he's back. I don't know how you don't feel anything from that speech, but what I want to say is that if it feels that way with him coming back, I don't want to say I would hate, but man, I don't know how I would feel when he retires, you know, and he gives a speech about his retirement. I don't even know how I would feel about that. That, man, I'm sure a lot of people are going to be in the fields, man. I'm sure a lot of people are going to be in the fields. But one thing that I would say is that, you know, with him and his creativity and his symbolism, it's second to none, especially in the wrestling world. I mean, he said at the end that he was in this dark, you know, place and that the fans brought him out. And obviously, I feel like, you know, it's up to Bray Wyatt, obviously, if that's the case, that him coming out of that door was symbolic of him coming out of that dark place. But having that lantern, the same exact color as the lights that the fans had in the stand, it represented the fans helping him out of his dark place and coming out of that darkness of depression and self-doubt and not feeling like himself. Like, his whole entire speech just felt so genuine and heart-to-heart, man. It just, I don't know what to say, man. I really don't know what to say. But, man, I'm happy he's back. I You know, I'm just curious on what's next. Is he going to actually go into a feud with somebody, or is this something that he's going to do when it's a feud against him versus himself to kind of represent this whole coming out of depression thing and eventually turn into a face and then be this person to kind of help people out of that dark place or whatever the case may be. But I do love the fact that he always gives references to other things and then he makes it into his own world and recreate it. Like, his, like obviously the Fiend's mask is the new 52 Joker. The mask that he has now from what I believe, I don't know what you want to call the guy. You know, some people say the White Rabbit. I guess we don't really have a name per se for the guy. But obviously it's the Black Phone mask. If you guys haven't seen that movie, that's where it came from. And I'm just looking forward to whatever horror movie he's coming out with. I know he's been working on one for a long time and he hasn't released anything about it yet. But man, this dude, I don't know if anyone who goes through a bunch of characters in the history of wrestling, right? Excluding maybe Mick Foley, that every character is something super creative and something different. I don't think we've ever experienced this level of creativity when it comes to a wrestler and controlling how they do things, probably ever, in my personal opinion. And I've always wondered if not Malakai Black, but I'm going to call him Aleister Black since we're talking about WWE, what if he came back and allowed Bray Wyatt to have a hand in creative when it comes to how they handle his character? Can you imagine how crazy that would be? That would be fantastic. But again, I don't want to make this too long. It blew me away. I don't know what else to say. But anyways, what do you guys think? Let me know in the comment section. This was fantastic, man. I'm looking forward to what he does next. Thank you guys so much for watching this video with me. Salute. Peace. Have a good day.